Hello, friends. We continue our reading classes, and today we will read a short story by Ray Bradbury, All Summer in a Day. It rained. On the planet Venus, it had been raining for 7 years. Thousands of days were filled with crystal showers and heavy storms. The children were standing near the large window of their schoolroom. They were waiting. It's stopping, it's stopping. Yes, yes. Marco stood apart from these children, who couldn't remember a day without rain. They were all 9 years old, and if they had been a day 7 years ago, when the sun came out for an hour and showed its face to the world, they forgot it. All day yesterday they were reading in class about the sun, and they had written small stories or poems about it. I think the sun is a flower that blooms for just 1 hour. That was Margot's poem. She read it in a quiet voice while the rain was falling outside.
No, you didn't write that, protested one of the boys.
I did, said Margot. Now it was raining again. Margot looked as if she had been lost in the rain for years, and the rain had washed out the blue from her eyes and the red from her mouth. She looked like an old photograph dusted from an album. Now she stood watching the rain and the wet world beyond the huge glass. Suddenly, a boy gave her a strong push, but she did not move, and this was because she would play no game with them. If they tagged her and ran, she stood looking at them and did not follow. When the class sang songs about happiness and games, she didn't join them. Only when they sang about the sun, her lips made a slow move. Her biggest crime of all was that she had come here only 5 years ago from Earth. She remembered the sun, its color and its heat.
It's like a penny, she said once, eyes closed.
No, it's not, the children cried.
It's like a fire, she said, in the stove.
You are lying, you don't remember, cried the children. But she remembered. She was different, and they kept away from her. They knew that her father and mother would take her back to Earth next year. And so the children hated her for all these reasons. They hated her pale snow face, her waiting silence, her thinness, and her possible future.
Get away, cried the boy angrily.
Well, don't wait here. You will see nothing. It was a joke, wasn't it? He turned to the other children. Nothing's happening today, is it?
Nothing, nothing, the other children laughed and shook their heads.
Oh, but, Margot whispered, this is the day the scientists predict the sun.
All a joke, said the boy. Let's put her in a closet before the teacher comes.
They caught her, took into a closet, and locked the door. They stood looking at the door and saw it tremble from her beating against it. They heard her cries. Then, smiling, they turned and went out just as the teacher arrived.
Ready, children?
She looked at her watch.
Yes, said everyone.
Then the rain stopped and the world got silent. It was so unbelievable that the children felt they had lost their hearing. The door opened and the smell of the silent world came in. The next moment, the sun came out. It was the color of flaming bronze and it was very large. And the sky was flaming blue. The children ran out, crying into the springtime.
Don't go too far, called the teacher. You've got only 2 hours, you know.
But they were running and turning their faces up and feeling the sun on their faces. They were taking off their jackets and letting the sun burn their arms. When they got tired, the children stopped running. They were standing in the great jungle. The trees never stopped growing.
They were the color of rubber from the many years without sun. It was the color of stones and white cheese, and it was the color of the moon. The children ran among the trees. They slipped and fell. They pushed each other. They played hide and seek and tag. But most of all, they looked at the sun until the tears ran down their faces. They put their hands up to it and that amazing blue sky. They looked at everything and enjoyed everything. Then, wildly, like animals escaped from their caves, they ran and ran in circles. They had been running for an hour and did not stop running. And then, in the middle of their running, one of the girls gave a cry. Everyone stopped. The girl held out her hand. "Oh, look, look," she said, trembling. It was a raindrop. She began to cry, looking at it. They glanced quietly at the sun. A few cold drops fell on their noses, their cheeks, and their mouths. The sun hid behind the clouds. A wind blew cold around them. They turned and started to walk back toward their house. Lightning struck 10 miles away, 5 miles away, a mile, a half mile. The sky darkened. They stood in the doorway of the underground for a moment, until it was raining hard. Then they closed the door and heard the gigantic sound of the rain. Will it be 7 more years? Yes, 7. Then one of them gave a little cry. Marco! What? She's still in the closet where we locked it. They looked at each other and then looked away. Outside it was raining now. Their faces were white. They looked at their hands and feet, their faces down. They walked slowly down the hall in the sound of cold rain. They came to the closed door slowly and stood by it. Behind the closed door was only silence. They unlocked the door and let Margot out. You can find many other short stories and novels by this outstanding writer at D.I.Чижевського library.